On Friday.
This is good Friday.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين. ثم أما بعد، باب إثبات صفة الستر لله سبحانه وتعالى. So this attribute about Allah سبحانه وتعالى put his coverage and veil over the sinners. عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم saying إن الله يبني المؤمن فيضع عليه كنفه ويسره. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the believer close to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will put his his coverage, his screen on him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect him from exposing what he did of sins. فيقول أتعرف ذنب كذا أتعرف ذنب كذا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, do you remember, do you know such sin you did before, do you remember? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will repeat twice. فيقول نعم أي رب. Yes my رب. I remember. حتى إذا قرره بذنوبه ورأى في نفسه أنه هلك. Until the believer will confess that he did the sin and confirm that he committed this sin, and he think that he would be punished by going to hellfire. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى said سترتها عليك في الدنيا وأنا أغفرها لك اليوم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, I protected you, I screen you, I put my veil on you, and nobody knows about your sin in dunya, and today I will forgive you your sin, يوم القيامة. فيعطى كتاب حسناته, and then he will be given his book of good deeds. وأما الكافر والمنافقون فيقول الأشهاد هؤلاء الذين كذبوا على ربهم ألا لعنة الله على الظالمين. So the disbeliever and the hypocrites, الأشهاد, and he recited the ayah, those who lie to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be upon those who are transgressors. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم I heard رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say كل أمتي معافى إلا المهاجرين. All my ummah will be saved, will be protected except مجاهرين. المجاهرين. Those who expose their sin, who will sin in public, or they make the sin and then they will say we did so and so. وإن من المجاهرة أن يعمل الرجل بالليل عملا. And Rasulullah describing to expose a sin is to someone will commit a sin at night. ثم يصبح وقد ستره الله عليه. And he will wake up in the morning under the cover of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فيقول so this sinner will say to people يا فلان oh man عملت البارحة كذا وكذا I did so and so yesterday وقد بات يستره ربه ويصبح يكشف ستر الله عنه. So he spent the night even doing the sin but under the cover and the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will wake up and uncover the veil of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him, the protection that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did. So again, the main purpose of Imam Bukhari is to confirm and tell us about attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah will put his screen on us. Allah will cover us with his veil to protect us from doing anything else, like especially speaks about sins. So this is number one. But the other benefit of the hadith that, we sin. We have desires and we are not angels, and the nature of son of Adam is to commit sin. So if you commit sin, or if I commit a sin, number one is don't tell anyone, keep it between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah ghafur rahim, Allah may forgive it. And according to the hadith, especially to the believers, to the Muslims that believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his rahmah and out of his mercy and generosity, his karam subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah will forgive the sin. And we have to have again yaqeen, assurance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive the sin. And this is min husn al-dhan, the good thinking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the good expectation that you have about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah is ghafoor rahim, as long as you come with good tawheed and good belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So number one, don't tell anyone. Keep it between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. to hoping that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala will cover you with this hadith. And number two is to do the tawbah right away. يعني again we make sense, but again the moment you sin, right away remember Allah Subhanahu wa Taala and ask Allah Subhanahu wa Taala for the tawbah, and Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is Ghafoor Rahim. So again, in this beautiful hadith, we learn number one is don't tell anyone, and number two is to make tawbah to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. أقول قولي هذا وصف الله لربك فصفونا وغفور رحيم. السلام عليكم.
مجاهرين ليس مهاجرين.